Hello and welcome to our very special Mirror Now show, India Inspires, where we bring you stories of the Good Samaritans who have stepped up and are a ray of hope at this unprecedented times for all those in need and for the underprivileged who are looking at an uncertain future and a frightening present. We bring you stories of all these Good Samaritans who have stepped up and who are helping the needy in every way possible, becoming an inspiration for all those who want to follow their footsteps. We are going to be introducing you three such individuals on this show, and we will tell you about how they have been operating, how many people they have helped so far, and what is it that inspires them to do it. Let me go across to my first guest on this show, Dr. Hansaji Yogendra, who is the director of the Yoga Institute. Remember, this is the world's oldest yoga institute, and this initiative has in fact helped a lot of those unsung heroes of COVID-19. All of those who include the policemen, the BMC staff, the medical staff, all these individuals who are at the front line at this point, helping our country fight coronavirus. Let me also introduce our other guest, Deepak Singh, the Mumbai head of the Robin Army. Remember, the Robin Army has always been working towards helping the underprivileged and those in need, serving them meals. And this time, they're also doing the same by giving out ration, dry ration and cooked meal food packets to the homeless in Mumbai. My third guest on this show is Dominic, who is a member of the COVID-19 Relief Bengaluru. Now, the COVID-19 Relief Bengaluru is a combination of the Xavier's Alumni Organization and NGO Diaghar, which works for the migrants in Bengaluru. And so far, they have been able to map more than 10,000 families in Bengaluru. Remember, the migrant population was the worst affected at this point because they have been staring at an uncertain future with absolutely no source of livelihood. And with this initiative, they have been able to help a lot of these migrants and daily wagers with some kind of relief package. I welcome you all on the show, and we salute the kind of work that you have been doing, and you have been an inspiration for everyone at this point and for all those who want to follow your footsteps at this point. Let me first begin by going to Dr. Yogendra. Dr. Yogendra, you have been a part of the Yoga Institute for decades, but this initiative, tell us about it. How did you start this initiative of helping all those who are at the front line? We're talking about the policemen, we're talking about the BMC workers, we're talking about the medical staff who have to be there at the front line fighting the coronavirus pandemic while the rest of the country right now stays at home.
Right. You see, what happens is that all these people, they don't have time even to sit and eat. They need some very healthy food, which would help them to develop a good immunity and help them to see that their energy level is very high. Otherwise, they won't be able to function. And so we give them what is called a sattvic food. Sattvic food is a food which is easily digestible. It gives you lots of energy, fibrous, and it really helps in cleansing your system. So that is one work which we do it since quite a long time. You see, the police force has been coming here very regularly for yoga training. And one of the police in the morning, when I asked him, did you eat your food? He says, madam, no time. So I decided, I said, come on, how many people? And accordingly, we give them breakfast, we give them lunch, we give them snacks, dinner. We cook food here in the institute with our in-house cooks. We have in-house people who are staying here day in and day out. We have foreigners staying here. We have about 50 of foreigners who are coming from various countries. They have been staying here and learning yoga. They all are so helpful in helping others. And so we try to cook, we make a packet, and then we tell these police to come in their van, take the things and go. Now we are trying to see that we reach still more people. This was around 1,000. And now we are reaching more people because we find the poor urchins here around. They also are looking for food. And so we told police as well as municipality heads that they should take food from us. We don't know where to go and give. They should give to needy people around. And so this is how we have made the arrangement. And along with it, we try to see that they get little education on how they should eat little food, but a healthy food, a simple food, so that would help them to cope up with this stress, which is going to which is there and which is going to be there further also. And another thing which we do is we have our programs which are going on online, where we try to talk to people. Thousands of people, they are joining me in on this online, and they try to understand what to do, how to do. And the basic philosophy of yoga is being understood very well, that right now be present, do your job perfectly, see that you follow all these rules and regulations properly, see that you drink only hot water after eating food, and so many details which I give it online, which people are following. And I find that all of them are really healthy, fit, and fine.
Absolutely. Dr. Hansaji, this is very important because the food that you're serving is essentially going to keep them healthy. It's going to keep them going. And the initiative like this is definitely the need of the hour, especially for all those people who are at the front line, who are battling this coronavirus day in and day out, while the rest of us right now can stay at home and stay safe. Hansaji, I request you to stay with us at this point. Let me also go across to Dominic, who is also a member of the COVID-19 Relief Bengaluru. Dominic, many thanks for speaking to us. Tell us about your initiative and what really inspired you to start with this, because you're focusing on the migrant population, the daily wagers, who we have seen were the worst affected with this lockdown. They have absolutely no source of livelihood. They have no source of income. They're literally staring at an uncertain future at this point. Their present is absolutely frightening. How did you come up with this initiative, and what has been your journey like when you've been reaching out to all of these migrant population?
Thank you for having me, and I must not take the credit individually at all, because it was a group of people who just got together. It started off with one of our linchpins of this organization, Aparna. She just decided that she wanted to help a few people in our neighborhood, and then as a model worked, then we went ahead and said if we can kind of help as many people as we want. So we targeted 10,000 people that we wanted to help with, because through some calculations, we came to the conclusion that there are close to 3 lakh people who are affected by this entire debacle. And we said, can we go ahead and at least influence or help and mitigate the problems people have? And our numbers that we hit was 10,000. To manage most of our work, what we did was we roped in a lot of groups and organizations like Deagar, the Jesuit institutions, XLR, of course, is spearheading this whole the whole activity. We also have participation from FMS, IIM Calcutta, Rotary Club, Azim Premji Foundation just joined hands with us. So the list is kind of endless, and people are joining. And what is really interesting is participation from individuals as much as organizations, right? So all our last mile work is done by NGOs who have repositioned themselves. Apart from doing the work that they do on a regular day job, they've joined hands with us on this. Various individuals have come together. So we have people who are retired, sitting at home, nothing to do. So therefore, they've become the call center for us, who help map people who are in dire need for help. We've had students who joined hands. We are NCC cadets, the social work groups, various organizations who are doing a lot of distribution work. Metro Cash and Carry, Big Basket, they've joined hands with us. So what has happened is we've been able to impact close to 6,000 families, and each family comprises of around 5 people. So far, we've been able to source 70 tons of rice, 17 tons of dal, 7 tons of oil, 28 tons of potatoes, salt and sambar powder, which has been getting distributed on a daily basis. And we've had the government organizations who are helping us as much as they can, because we kind of become a shot in the arm for them right now. So that's it. And we have a group of people with varied interests, varied ideologies, varied beliefs, different thought processes, all come together to join hands, to instead of just sitting and debating this over WhatsApp and on Facebook messages and groups, to make a difference on the ground.
All right. Dominic, request you to stay with us at this point. It's, of course, extremely important to note the kind of work that all the organizations are doing at this point, especially to help the migrant population who have been worst affected. Let me also go across to Deepak Singh, who's the Mumbai head of the Robin Hood Army. Deepak, many thanks for speaking to us. And we know that the Robin Hood Army has been working in a lot of cities in the past as well, reaching out to the underprivileged and those in need and serving them food. But this time around, at this hour of crisis, how are you operating, especially in a city like Mumbai, which has been worst affected, and the number of cases of coronavirus has been going up?
Thanks, Apurva, for inviting me in this show. Actually, Robin Hood Army is a volunteer-based organization. But when the lockdown came on 23, we saw many people starving outside our home, because we are working in the cluster for the underprivileged people from last 6 years. So we know the ground reality. So we decided instead sitting at home and watching TV and staying at home, let's do something for these people who are starving. They are not getting enough of the food. So Robin Hood India come up with an initiative which is called Senior Patrol. In that, we just requested every citizen just mail us ki where are the citizens who need food and medicines. We will go there and we will give them food and medicines. In the same way, in Navi Mumbai area, I'm staying in Mumbai, we found that many of the slum, daily wages workers, migrant workers, they are not getting food. We start getting call from many people. As we are working, people know us ki Robin Hood ek aisa organization hai jo kabhi na kabhi, matlab kahin pe bhi call karo, wo aayenge hi. And ye faith tha jo humko ek power diya. Then we asked the police, we asked the corporation ki we want to carry such type of drive. हमको खाना देना है लोगों को, तो हाउ कैन वी कोलैबोरेट. देन कॉर्पोरेशन ने बोला यू आर वेलकम एंड यू कैन गो अहेड विद द प्लान. एंड पुलिस से हम लोगों ने हेल्प मांगा और पुलिस को हेल्प लेकर के हम बाहर गए और लोगों को ग्रेन्स जो 15 केजी का पैकेट्स दिया हम लोगों ने, 10 किलो का, जो 8 से 10 दिन का उनका राशन हो जाएगा. द होल प्लान वॉज कि अगर हम उनको राशन देते हैं तो एटलीस्ट दे विल सिट एट होम एंड दे विल फॉलो द लॉकडाउन. एंड उसके बाद हम लोगों ने देखा कि बहुत सारे होमलेस पीपल है जिनके पास खाना नहीं है, तो हम लोगों ने होमलेस पीपल को कुक्ड फूड देना शुरू किया है. इन दैट मेनी अदर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन लाइक रोटरी, देन रिलायंस फाउंडेशन, अदर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन लाइक फासोस हैव कम अप विद अस एंड वी आर ऑल प्लान टुगेदर एंड वी आर जस्ट सर्विंग द फूड टू दिस पीपल. इसमें बहुत सारे इंडिविजुअल्स भी हैं जो हमारे साथ आ रहे हैं. और नॉट ओनली इन मुंबई, वी आर वर्किंग दिस ऑल अक्रॉस इंडिया. मुंबई में हमारे ऑलमोस्ट 100 से ज्यादा वॉलंटियर है जो अभी ग्राउंड पे हैं, बट विद प्रॉपर सेफ्टी, प्रॉपर प्रिकॉशन. एंड हम लोग एक सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग को बहुत ज्यादा महत्व दे रहे हैं कि कहीं पे भी किसी से साथ कॉन्टैक्ट में ना आ पाए और सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग मेंटेन होते करते हुए इन लोग को हम एक अच्छे तरीके से फूड को सर्व कर सकें. एंड ऑलमोस्ट एज पर माई कैलकुलेशन टिल दैट वी हैव सर्व द ग्रेन्स टू 1000 फैमिली अक्रॉस मुंबई नाउ. And cooked food jo hai more than 5 to 10,000 people hum log target kar rahe hain isme. And this initiative, this jo ye khana khilana hamara jo kaam hai, ye hum continue rakhenge jab tak ki ye lockdown ki sthiti rahegi. And in Mumbai we will not starve any people across the city. हम लोग ने लोगों को रिक्वेस्ट भी किया है कि अगर कहीं पे भी किसी को खाने की जरूरत है, कोई माइग्रेंट वर्कर्स हैं, कोई ऐसे होमलेस है जिनको खाना नहीं मिल रहा है, इमीडिएटली हमको आप मेल कीजिए, कॉल कीजिए. वी विल प्लान समथिंग, वी विल डू समथिंग एंड वी विल डेफिनेटली ट्राई टू रीच देम एंड वी विल गिव देम फूड. दिस आवर कमिटमेंट. एंड हमारे वॉलंटियर्स में एक एंथुसियाज्म है, एक सेल्फ बोलते हैं मोटिवेशन है एंड ये सक्सेसफुली हम कर पा रहे हैं इस सिटी में एटलीस्ट. And although Mumbai is at high risk and we have asked all the volunteers to take the proper safety so that ki we should not be the carrier of any kind of virus. So we are taking proper precaution and we are just serving food to all the people across the city. As well as we are trying
undoubtedly, to... Undoubtedly, Deepak, these are initiatives like these. Yes. Absolutely. Please go on.
And this is not only the first case. We were active during the flood there, Mumbai. Jabhi Mumbai mein bhi water logging hua tha, so we are always there to help the people, and we are always committed to help the people. So it's the total teamwork. हमारे जो volunteers हैं, जो working professionals हैं, काफी लोग housewives हैं, लेकिन हम लोग ने इसमें कुछ criteria रखे अपने volunteers के लिए कि the people, those who are below 30 can only come on the ground, and जिसके घर पे pregnant wife है, छोटे बच्चे हैं, सीनियर सिटीजन्स हैं, वो प्लीज इधर आने के बदले आप घर पे बैठ के हमको बैक सपोर्ट करिए कि हमको खाना कहाँ मिल रहा है, कहाँ पे लोग हैं, एंड जो वॉलंटियर्स कम्प्लीटली हेल्दी हैं, जिनके घर पे मतलब निकलने के इसमें है, दे कैन ओनली कम ऑन द ग्राउंड बट विथ पुलिस एंड प्रॉपर परमिशन फ्रॉम द कॉर्पोरेशन. सो पुलिस का हम लोग इसमें बहुत
Absolutely. ये सारी जो initiatives आप बता रहे हैं, this is actually the need of the hour and this is what is really making a difference on ground. You're helping out all those in need while also making sure that your volunteers and those who are helping you are also safe. You're maintaining all the social norms, which is a clear example of what people need to be doing. The fact that they can really help people while practicing every rule that is in place, and that's really a testament of how things can be done, how you and I can really contribute to this entire thing. Deepak, request you to stay with us at this point, and it is really an inspiration to listen to all of you and the kind of work that each and every individual is currently doing on ground. You and your volunteers collectively are helping all those in need. Dr. Hansaji, would like to understand from you, you have so far been able to at least deliver meals to almost 1,000 people per day, and that's a very big contribution on a daily basis. What is your roadmap ahead? How many people are you aiming to deliver these Sattvic meals too, and what are the big challenges before you while you do it?
Well, since we are dealing with householders, our entire education is to see okay. that how a family should help each other live jointly together and all that. I always tell people that just don't live for yourself, live for others, do whatever you could do for others, do. So all these things which I heard was so beautiful that everybody is doing fantastic job, no doubt about it. The point is how to take care of their mind. When they are doing any work, they should understand that they should not bring any fear, anxiety, tension. They should just follow the rules and regulations of how to live correctly. And so now we are going to increase our number. We can go up to 2,000. And wherever we feel the need is there, we would definitely help them out. Because our main aim is to see that the health is to be maintained. It's not just the food, whatever comes. They have no time to cook and all. They don't have a gases. People are telling me, we don't have gas. Where would we cook? And so people need cooked food. And so we thought that we would cook. My in-house team is working day in and day out to see that they could do their job well. And they are doing it very enthusiastically. I have noticed that all our volunteers, they are all volunteers. Our institute is totally a non-profit organization since all these 100 years. I'm in Mumbai, but all these. And so they are all there with positive feeling, dedication to do the job. And we could reach up to 2,000, that much though, I think so we will be able to manage. And if we could get help, nothing like that, but we would definitely go ahead with that. And let us know where, what is required and how scientifically we could go ahead and do that. We have seen that there were people who were very sick in bed. They couldn't digest anything. They were going down. There were people who were drinking alcohol and spending the time because there is a tension in the house. And all such people, once they started eating this food, their health improved. There are many who have stopped drinking alcohol. There are many who were totally bedridden. Now they come walking up to our gate. Our gate is locked, but they come up to our gate to tell us that thank you very much. Now we are alive. So we are enthusiastic and we would definitely do all these things. Educate people how to live, try to do this. Our cook, which you can see, all this, our team, they are all this, my son, Shri, Rishi Yogendra, all such people which you are seeing now, they are very, very sincere, dedicated, and they would do their, they are doing their job very well. Police is very happy. They are also telling us that we are helpful. This food is helpful to bring our health, to bring our okay. health in balance. So we will do, we will go ahead.
And that really, Dr. Hansaji, is the most important. The fact that there is physical and mental well-being, that in fact is the most important aspect of making sure that all those in the front line, especially the medical staff, the paramedics, the BMC staff, and all those policemen who are at the front line day in and day out, have not just a physical well-being, but they are mentally sound as well. And that is an initiative that you have very beautifully put forth to them. Dr. Hansaji, requested to stay with us. And this is important because we have have also been talking a lot about the daily wages, the migrant population, which has been worst affected. Dominic, would like to understand from you, you've been able to map more than 10,000 families at this point. While, of course, you're looking at mapping more families and reaching out to all of these people. Help us understand, how are your network, how do you network around with all these people? Because you have a vast network, you partner with a lot of NGOs. Is that a challenging task for you? Because you have a lot of people who are coming out to help.
So I missed the last part of your question. So what I heard from you is, how are we managing this? So let me just try and tell you what we're accomplishing here, right? So the large group of people that we have, we've divided ourselves into either interest levels or in terms of expertise that we have, right? So we have people who worked in supply chain for large organizations in their past. We've worked with a lot of, there are a bunch of people who've done various things like distribution and sourcing. So there are a bunch of people who are raising funds. So what we do is, every day morning, we're going to call at 9 o'clock, and each of us are assigned or understand what's the kind of work that we need to do. And each group is led by one set of people, right? So there is a group of people who are just focused on raising funds. There's a group of people who are just sourcing material from various parts of the city and various yards that have grains. And people like me are trying two or three things. One is trying to manage requirement needs, which comes from the city, and also help in communication.
Okay.
One people which purely manages distribution. The challenges that we're currently facing is last mile distribution, right? So because we have partnered with various NGOs, what we also have tried on, I take this as a forum to request. We ask people to donate safely and volunteer safely. And this volunteer safely is a very interesting piece. Let's just assume that you're walking on the streets. I mean, now you can't really walk on the streets, but if you know of a family which is in dire need, you can just get onto our Facebook page, Twitter, Instagram, or whatever, and just let us know the requirement needed. So that's your contribution as an individual. You don't really have to go out and do any work. For us, you can just pick up the phone, and there are people waiting on the other side of the line who will answer your call, who will have a bunch of validation questions from you. And then all that you need to give us is a GPS location. And then in the back end, we'll find a way to get the kits delivered to you. Right? So that way we can have the entire city participate. And then if you really want to go out and make a donation, we're more than happy for us to use your money in helping the needy. Right. So also just well one more. What we're also trying to do is come up with articles and research publications, if we can, in terms of the impact of starvation versus the other economical challenges that we are going to be you kind of going to be challenging in the future, right? So we're looking at various aspects, from intellectual contribution to scholarly contribution to working on the street to, you know, managing distribution to supply chain to just getting in requests. And we're just grateful for all the people who have come. And a very interesting part that I must mention is, none of us have met each other before. Right, all of us are operating from home, except for maybe a few folks from XLRI. All of us just come together, and the calls happen in the morning, and we haven't met.
And that really, Dominic, is the important aspect. Absolutely, Dominic, that really is the important aspect, that all of you are functioning while observing the social norms, not flouting any of the rules. And more importantly, you've been able to make a significant contribution and reach out to all of those people while maintaining the social distancing, while maintaining all those requirements right now to fight the virus. And this is the message that really is coming out from all of the people that we just spoke to. The important aspect is how you and I can really contribute. And this is the kind of message that we're sending across, that you and I can also contribute in our own way to help those in need. Many thanks to our guest for joining us and giving us an understanding of how you've been helping out people, and you absolutely have been an inspiration for all the Indians who probably would be following your footsteps. Dr. Hansaji, Dominic Vijay and Deepak Singh, many thanks for speaking to us, and we salute the kind of work that you've been doing, and we wish you luck for the work that you've been doing, and we hope that more people join in your fight against coronavirus and helping out all those in need.